Never in my wildest dreams did I imagine a result like this. Oh, how ironic that Dr. Leon Eccles, referred to in scholarly journals as a giant in his field, should die a groveling insect, the most despised of insects. I had hoped to save the world from the tortures of disease. Instead, I condemn myself to an ignominious future. Life is an overwhelming paradox. And Alice, my little daughter, so soon to become a lovely young bride, what have I done to her, the joy of my days? She shall die of a vile disease manufactured by these hands. And I, every hour becoming more disfigured, can do nothing at all to save her. Even the torment of death she'll suffer is preferable to this serum I've prepared. For my little one to undergo this change, even to save her life, would be abhorrent. Yet when I have completely changed, I'll be alone in the world. If I were to inject Alice with the serum, I could save her life and have a companion in my misery. When she was just a child, she used to cling to me. I remember her little voice, "Oh, Papa, let me come play in your laboratory. Let me stay with you. Don't ever leave me." Perhaps she really meant it. Perhaps she really would rather be with her Papa, even though it means, oh, my God, what am I saying? How could I entertain such a thought to do this to my little girl? Not only is my body changing, but I'm becoming more and more deranged, deranged, mad, mad.
Papa! Papa! Please allow me to speak with you. I don't know what's wrong, but I just can't abide the thought of your being locked in there alone. Papa, it's been 2 days since we've seen you. Oh, Papa!
Alice! You must try to understand, I cannot come out. I'm trying to think. Believe me, it's far better I stay locked in here. Perhaps I'll find an answer.
Oh, an answer? An answer? To what? To what? Papa, Mama's in a state of collapse. She weeps all day. I fear she's becoming too frail to endure this. You must give us some explanation.
Alice, my little one, I only wish I could be with you and open with you. I wish I could pour out my troubled soul, but I cannot. You must understand. I do this for your sake and for the sake of your dear mother. Please believe that I would not hurt you for the world.
Papa! Papa! I'll try to understand, but Papa, it's difficult. Now I must go to Mama.
She rushes off to be with her mama. But what of me? I am the one who's living in torment. I am the one who suffers. Wait a minute. Alice, she should be desperately ill by now, and yet she's seen quite well. That could not be. The virus is far too potent not to have affected her. This is the viral solution I've prepared. Alice must have dropped something completely harmless. She was never in any danger at all. What have I done to myself in vain? All in vain. I must get out of here. I must be free. My voice is failing me. I can no longer communicate with my fellow man. But I am no longer a man. I am a roach. The most frightening of creatures magnified to human dimensions. Think of the power I can command. Everyone will flee in fear of me. I can enjoy the most sumptuous home, warmth and comfort, plenty of luxuriant table scraps. Table scraps. Whole battalions of chefs will be forced to prepare the finest meals just for me. And to think I was unhappy about this change. Humans are so foolish, and I was the most foolish of all. But now to escape. To get out. To be free!
Eee!
house. Perhaps I can catch you unaware. She won't realize it at first, the happiness I'm about to give her.
Justin, I just went down to Papa's lab again, and he's not there. And Justin, the window is broken. Apparently, he hurled himself through it, yet I saw no blood. Oh, Justin, I'm insane with worry. I can't even begin to imagine what's happening to him.
Not certain I understand myself, Alice, but it's time you knew what your father has been working on. The explanation for his peculiar behavior most certainly lies in his experiment.
Yes, it is high time I knew.
He's been experimenting now for some time with roaches.
Roaches? How disgusting!
Yes, but his motives are commendable. He believes that he can discover the reason roaches remain invulnerable to the diseases they carry. He believes their bodies secrete a vital antiviral fluid that he can transform into a vaccine of sorts.
To rid the world of disease forever. Yes, that sounds like Papa. His concern for humanity is all-embracing.
Your father is indeed a fine person and a fine scientist. Recently, he became certain he had hit on the precise combination of secretions and chemicals to perfect his vaccine. He was about to experiment with a rabbit when you dropped that solution in his lab.
But what could that have to do with...
That solution was the virus he had prepared to inject the rabbit before he administered the vaccine. It's supposed to be deadly, that's why...
But I feel fine!
Yes, yes, he must have mixed up the jars. He was desperately afraid that the solution you dropped would cause your death, so he...
Oh, Justin! Oh, no! Has he injected himself?
Yes, I tried to reason with him, but he was irrational with concern for you. Now I fear that the experiment has backfired and that your father is the victim. Whether it has altered his brain, perhaps disrupted his metabolism, I have no idea. Perhaps this bizarre behavior pattern of his is only temporary.
Yes, Justin, perhaps so. Justin! The monster! Get it!
Why, it's a giant roach. It must be one of the creatures your father was using in his experiments, grotesquely mutated. There's one effective way to get rid of these vile things.
Oh, Justin! Do something, Justin! Oh, Justin! Mother! Justin!
Alice, have no fear. This will destroy the monster.
What have I done?
The only thing you could have done, my love. I don't know how we'll go on without him, but life would have been a torment for him as he had become.
He saw a breakthrough so near at hand.
How could this have happened?
His victory was so close, yet so very far.
Oh, and if I can carry on his noble work, someday this victory will be achieved.
Oh.